Hey everyone, Rodney here at Klebs Tech, and today we're going to be going over a few styles for Stable Diffusion. Now, since there are tons of styles out there, I'm just going to be talking about a few in this video. I do plan on more videos to cover more styles in the future. I will be using Focus today since that is my primary tool, but most of these are not specific to Focus, and even the ones that are can be added to the others. Now, if you're not familiar with styles, I do have a video that goes into more depth on styles with Focus and how they work. But in this video, we'll be discussing specific styles and their effects. But to give you a basic overview, styles are really just more words that are added to your prompt. You could accomplish the same thing by just using those same words, but styles make it easier. But it is important to know what the styles are doing, because if you use multiple styles, they could be fighting against each other, and you're not going to get the results that you're looking for. This is the reason I usually suggest applying one style at a time if you're not sure how they might impact the image. Today I'm going to be looking at a few of the photographic styles. The list of styles I'm using are included with Focus and can be found in the Style tab. At the top, you can use a search bar to find any specific styles you may be looking for. Now in Focus, they do give a small thumbnail preview of each style, but that really doesn't show that much of what it does. I will probably have an upcoming video on a better way to view what styles do, but I'm still experimenting with that tool. So one thing I do want to mention to anyone who uses Focus, the Focus V2 style is different than all the other styles, where the other styles always add the same words to the prompt. The V2 is GPT-2 for a dynamic prompt expansion, and it's supposed to improve the results. I usually recommend turning it off when experimenting, because what happens is when you generate, if we go into the log here where I generated these images, if you look at the prompt, this is what it changed it to. So this was my original prompt. This is what it changed it to. And that's different than this one. And that's different than this one. So for each generation, it's changing that section of the prompt expansion. This can really make the images look better. And it's one of the reasons Focus generates good images out of the box. But it also introduces unpredictability. So best not to use it when experimenting. And I'm not going to be using it today. So today we're going to be looking at mostly the photographic styles, not every single photographic styles because they're quite a bit, but these are the most popular, some of the default ones in Focus, so I'm going to cover those. Now the SAI, MRE, those are just the abbreviations for who came up with the styles, like Stability AI. And for Focus users, Focus Sharp and Enhance is usually the default one that's enabled. So I do want to cover those as well and how they impact the images. Now, I'm not going to go into every single keyword that's used in the prompts because most of them I think are pretty obvious, especially if you're familiar with photography at all. I'm not an expert on photography. I'm more of an amateur, but so I don't want to dive into every single term and what exactly they mean. And that would be probably pretty boring. So let's just jump right into some of the images that I've generated and start looking at the comparisons. So the SAI photographic is one of the ones I think does very well. It's a very simple one. It doesn't add a ton of keywords. You can see where your prompt will be added in this style, where it's highlighted. And let's look at some of the comparison images that I did. So on these, I did the same two seeds. So I ran these two images first, then I did it with the style applied, the same seed on the same model. I used the Juggernaut and the Hello World more towards realistic models. So their default are gonna look more like photos at the top. So those will still look like photos, but it won't have some of those the extra look and style applied to it. On this one, you can definitely see the difference on it. It does make the pictures look a little bit better, look like they were taken more by a professional than the other ones. Now, if we go into the scenic view of a pond, these you can definitely see a big difference between the no style applied and the photographic style applied. I don't think there's any doubt on these, the difference. Now for the Focus photograph style, this one I'm not as big of a fan on. This one's geared towards making a more traditional photo, I find. Now, obviously whoever created this doesn't like Brad Pitt or something. I'm not sure because that's the first thing in the negative prompt. There's a lot of things in this negative prompt that I don't really think need to be added in most cases, so I'm not a huge fan of this style myself. But let's look at the results of this one. And if you compare the Focus photograph ones at the top and the SAI photographic ones at the bottom, you can definitely see the difference between the two. The ones at the top look like more traditional older photos in my view, whereas the ones at the bottom look like more digital modern photography. If we look at the scenic view of a pond in the early morning, I feel we get the same results from those as well. And on these, I actually found, I feel that the Juggernaut did a better job with this, but a lot of that can also do with the settings and the seeds and everything else. Our next one is going to be Focus Sharp. This one is specific to focus, but could be used in other tools as well. Now, this one does give it a little bit more of a cinematic look with the cinematic still, and then your prompt, and it does add some other keywords in there differently than the other ones, but it's definitely going more towards sharpness. You can notice in the negative, it's removing and wanting to remove anything blurry. So if you're trying to get those things, you'll want to remember not to use Focus Sharp. And if we look at the results from that between no style and the Focus Sharp style, you get that little bit of a cinematic feel to it, I feel. And the images are a little bit sharper, not drastically, but as with most styles, they don't necessarily severely alter the images. Same thing on these. You get a little bit sharper results, a little bit better looking, but that's always going to be the case in almost every circumstance. If you have no style with a very simple prompt, a lot of times you're not going to get a really good looking image. Now on to our next one would be Focused and Enhanced. Now this one doesn't add anything to the regular prompt. It only adds to the negative. And this one actually, I was surprised at how much of a difference it can make in pictures. If we look in here at the first ones, no style, and then just with the Focused Enhanced on the negative, you can see a definite improvement in the quality of the images, the color, the vibrancy, and everything else. Now, the same idea, if we go over into the pond, I feel these are even more drastic on the difference that it can make. Now, when we look at the Focus Photograph with the Focus Photograph and Focused Enhanced applied together, we can see a little bit of an improvement in the images. We do notice that these are, you know, everything looks a little bit better in each of these images. So it's taken that style and it's actually improved it a little bit more. And same idea, the top ones here are the SAI Photographic ones. And then the bottom ones are with the SAI Photographic and Focused Enhanced style added. And it definitely makes a big difference on those images as well. So combining multiple styles can make a big difference as long as they're not fighting against each other. Now, on to a couple of the more interesting ones here. Now, the Photo iPhone Photographic one is geared towards making it look like it was taken with an iPhone. Basically all that's to that. And what does that show for results? Well, I don't own an iPhone. So I'm assuming the idea is it's more of like a cell phone, things like that. So these are the sort of results you're gonna get. It definitely improves the picture. It is different than how the other ones because it's not necessarily going more for that professional look. The same idea with the iPhone Photographic in the compared to the no style with the scenic pond definitely makes a huge difference on those. When we look at the iPhone Photographic with the iPhone Photographic and Focused Enhanced, we can see the same idea. It takes those same images and theoretically improves upon them. But then again, that really depends on what you're going for the look. You may not be going for that specific look that you're getting with the enhanced. Now, the one thing I have noticed when I was doing a lot of these images, when it came to people, is one thing to note between these two models, which is not specific, but I did notice that the Hello World model seems to pull back further when it's doing these images. That's one thing I noticed when I was doing these prompts of just a person, whereas like the Juggernaut would zoom in more, the Hello World one is further out. The Hello World one would be a lot easier to get full body shots probably than Juggernaut is. Now, on to our next one is the MRE Spontaneous Picture one. I actually like this one because it can make your images, I find, look more natural, like not posed. You'll get less of a posed look. This is, you know, which makes sense looking at the keywords, taken by a talented amateur, magical moment, simple but good looking, natural look. Now, if we look at the results on this, between the style, no style and the spontaneous picture, I think it's pretty evident that the bottom ones, for the most part to me, look less posed. It's not as evident in these pictures as much, but usually that is the case with these. So it's not gonna drastically, the spontaneous picture doesn't necessarily drastically change it overall. Like I said, it just gives it that more natural, spontaneous picture look is what it's going for. Now, so if we compare, I did a different one here, A Beautiful Woman at the Park, and I used the photographic style and then used the spontaneous picture style. You know, the ones at the top definitely look like they're being posed for a photo and everything else, whereas the ones at the bottom look like they were just taken just out at the park on an everyday walk. So I find this is the one I recommend when I get a lot of people who ask me about, you know, how can I make my pictures look more natural and not professional posed and all this sort of stuff. And the spontaneous picture one I do find works well for that sort of thing. You can also add other keywords into the your prompts as well for that, like candid, casual. Now, when we look at using it with the iPhone photographic and the iPhone photographic spontaneous picture, not as much of a difference there, in all honesty. A little bit different, but not drastically different. I will leave you with one last style that you may not be aware of, no-ling photography. This one creates nice images like these with everything laid out. Now, that should give you some ideas on what some of the photographic styles you can use with Stable Diffusion and how they affect the images that you generate. In future episodes and styles, I do plan on diving more into the creative styles since those are what I use more often than the photographic ones, and those are a lot more fun. If you found this video helpful, please do consider hitting the like button. And of course, I do accept donations and would like to thank those who've donated since it does make a huge difference. I did just recently set up a Patreon account as well that I'll be using to help support the channel. And we'll be offering some things like free images with metadata from Focus. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.